Hi friends, welcome back to Mygovtrack channel. And in this video, we'll discuss some important objective questions from the thermodynamics. So this topic comes under the mechanical branch, and this video will be useful for electrical students also. So this is the part 3 of the thermodynamics. So before that, I have shared already two parts, thermodynamics part 1 and part 2. And if you want to watch that videos, you can go to the playlist BMCJ 2019, and under that you can watch these two videos. So let's start with the important objective questions from the thermodynamics part 3. So in this video, I will cover the next 50 questions. In earlier videos, I covered the first 50 questions in the part 1 and 2. So in this video, we will start with the 51. So 51, which of the following items is not a path function? So I told you earlier, what are the point function and what are the path functions? Point functions, that means that does not depend on path history. And the path functions depends on the path history. So heat and work, only these are the two examples of path function. And in this question, they're asking which of the following is not a path function. So thermal conductivity is the correct answer. So thermal conductivity is not a path function. And rest, that is heat, work, kinetic energy, VDP is nothing but work, open system work done. So these are the path functions. Thermal conductivity is not a path function. Correct answer is option E, thermal conductivity. Question number 52. Work done in an adiabatic process between a given pair of end states depends on what? Work done in an adiabatic process between a given pair of end states, that depends upon what? So work done depends upon end states only, right? Correct answer is option A. In adiabatic process, work done depends upon the end state, because what is the formula of work done in adiabatic process? So work done is nothing but P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1. So this is the formula of work done in an adiabatic process. So you can see it's a P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1. Gamma is the adiabatic index. So that depends upon the end states only. End state is nothing but, so at this end state, suppose this is the A point, this is the B point. This is A, this is B. So at this end, the pressure is P1 V1. At this end, the pressure is pressure P2 and volume V2. So this, like its end states. So work done in an adiabatic process depends on the end states only. Next, question number 53. Heat and work are path functions. I already told you, heat and work are path functions. The correct answer is option C, path functions. Next question. Question number 54, which of the following parameters is constant for a mole for the most of the gases at a given temperature and pressure? So at a given temperature and pressure, which of the following parameter is constant for a mole? So volume. Volume is constant for a mole for the most of the gases at a given temperature and pressure. Correct answer is option B, volume. Next question, question number 55. The value of N is equal to 1 in the polytropic process indicates to be which process? When value, that is P V raised to N is equal to C. So this is the equation. So in that equation, if N is equal to 1, they are asking if N is equal to 1, then it becomes which process? So P V is equal to 1. N equal to 1 means P V is equal to constant. Then this process is nothing but an isothermal process. So isothermal process, in that the temperature is constant. Okay, the correct answer for this is option B, isothermal process. Okay, next question, question number 56. Solids and liquids have what? Solids and liquids have one specific heat, two values of specific heat. Okay, solid and liquid. So this is having two values of specific heat. Okay, the first is specific heat at constant pressure, and the second is specific heat at constant volume. So if someone asks, solid and liquids have two values of specific heat. Correct answer is option A. The next question is question number 57. A perfect gas at 27 degrees Celsius is heated at constant pressure till its volume is double. Okay, the final temperature is, they're asking the final temperature. So the initial temperature is T1. I will write down as T1 initial temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, and initial volume, suppose initial volume is V1 and the volume becomes double, so final volume is 2V1. Okay, what they are given? Initial temperature T1, initial volume V1, final volume 2V1, and what we have to find out? T2 is equal to what? So, and what is the constant at constant pressure? When pressure is constant, see, volume is directly proportional to temperature when pressure is constant. Okay, so we have to use this formula. This formula is nothing but V1 by T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So by using this formula, just put the value of V1 as V and V2 as a 2V, and T1 and T2, you will get the value of T2, that is final temperature. And the correct answer for this is 327 degrees Celsius. So you have to convert that Kelvin, and after that it convert at degrees Celsius. So the correct answer is 327 degrees Celsius. Next, question number 58. The figure is not given as curve A in the figure compared to curve B and C shows the following type of expansion. The figure is not given, but I'll show you. So this is a PV, and this is the curve which denotes the isothermal process. Temperature is equal to constant. Okay, for isobaric process, that is pressure is equal to constant, the graph will be like this, and for isochoric process the graph will be like this. This is volume is equal to constant. Okay, and for isothermal process the graph will be like this. Next question, question number 59. If the value of n is infinitely large in a polytropic process, that is PV raised to n is equal to constant, then the process is known as constant volume process. Okay, so if you remember, this is the graph of PV, so it will indicate all the process, that is here P is equal to constant, that is PV is equal to, so when we put value of n is equal to 0, with 0, 1, n, then gamma, then infinity. Okay, this is the PV diagram. It indicates all the processes. When n is equal to 0, it becomes a constant pressure process. When n is equal to infinity, it becomes constant volume process. So what they are asking here, when n is infinitely large, in the polytropic process PV raised to n is equal to constant, the process is known as constant volume process. Option A is the correct answer. Coming to next question, question number 60. The index of compression n tends to reach the ratio of specific heats gamma when what? When the process is isentropic and the specific heat changes with the temperature, right? What the index of compression n tends to reach the ratio, that is its adiabatic index gamma, it reaches to the gamma value when the process is isentropic, right? When the process is isentropic, it reaches to the gamma value and the specific heat changes with temperature. Sorry, the correct answer is isentropic and the specific heat does not change with temperature. Okay, the correct answer is option D. The first statement is correct. The process is isentropic. Yeah, it should be isentropic. After that only it reaches to the value of gamma, that is adiabatic index, and the specific heat does not change with temperature. Next question, question number 61. Change in enthalpy of a system is the heat supplied at what? Change in enthalpy of a system is the heat supplied at constant pressure. The correct answer is option A, constant pressure. NTP stands for what? NTP stands for normal temperature pressure. Okay, NTP stands for normal temperature and pressure. Next question, question number 63. A heat exchange process in which the product of pressure and volume remains constant. Okay, product of pressure and volume, it remains constant. So that process is nothing but hyperbolic process. Okay, and when the temperature is remains constant, that process is known as isothermal process, right? The correct answer for this is option E. When the product of a pressure and volume remains constant, that process is known as hyperbolic process. Next question, in an isothermal process, the internal energy of a gas molecule what internal energy is remains constant, right? In an isothermal process, internal energy of a gas molecule remains constant. The correct answer is option C. Next, zeroth law of thermodynamics. So zeroth law, it deals with what? It deals with the temperature. And what is zeroth law? It states that if two systems are both in equilibrium with the third system, then they are in thermal equilibrium with each other, right? So zeroth law, I will explain, means this is body A, this is body B, and this is C. This is A, this is B, this is C. A and C are in thermal equilibrium and B and C are in thermal equilibrium, then body A and body B should be in thermal equilibrium. So this is the zeroth law. It measures the temperature. The correct answer for this is option C. Next question, question number 66. If a certain amount of dry ice is mixed with the same amount of water at 80 degrees Celsius, the final temperature of the mixture will be what? Okay, certain amount of dry ice is mixed with the same amount of water at 80 degrees Celsius. So what will happen? The same amount of water which is at 80 degrees Celsius will release the heat, okay, from 80 degrees Celsius to zero, and the dry ice will absorb this heat, and finally it becomes the equilibrium temperature. The correct answer for this is option B, zero, means after the equilibrium, the final temperature of the mixture will be the temperature of dry ice, that is 0 degrees Celsius. Correct answer is option B. Next question, question number 67. The basis for measuring thermodynamic property of temperature is given by what? Just now I told you the zeroth law of temperature is the measure of temperature. Okay, it is related to temperature. First law is related to the energy. Second law is related to the entropy. The correct answer for this is zeroth law related to the temperature. It measures the thermodynamic property, that is temperature. 1 watt is equal to what? 1 watt is equal to 1 newton meter per second. So correct answer is option A. Is the unit of power 1 watt. 1 watt is nothing but 1 newton meter per second. Question number 69. The work done is 0 for the following process. When work done is 0? So at a constant volume process, work done is 0, right? Because of what is the formula of work done? Work done is equal to integration of P into dV. When the volume is constant, then work done equal to 0. For free expansion as well as throttling process, work done is 0. The correct answer is option D, all of the above. Question number 70. For which of the following substances the gas law can be used with minimum error? The correct answer is option D. For superheated steam, the gas laws can be used with the minimum error. Next question, question number 73. On volume basis, air contains the following parts of oxygen. How many parts of oxygen? So 21 parts of oxygen on volume basis. Okay, on volume basis, air contains 21 parts of oxygen. Next question, question number 74. Universal gas constant is defined as equal to the product of molecular weight of the gas and what? Universal gas constant. So that denoted by like this, R bar, this is the universal gas constant. It is the product of molecular weight into what? So it's R, that is gas constant. It is the product of molecular weight and gas constant. The correct answer is option D. Question number 75. The value of the product of molecular weight and the characteristics gas constant for all gases in the SI unit is option B, 83.14 joule per kilomole degree Kelvin. This is the correct answer. For the product of molecular weight and the characteristics gas constant is nothing but the value of universal gas constant, R bar, or we can say that 8.314 kilojoule per kg per mole degree Kelvin. Okay. Question number 76. For which of the following substances the internal energy and enthalpy are the function of temperature only? So when the internal energy and enthalpy are the functions of temperature, for the case of perfect gas, correct answer is option D. For the case of perfect gas, the internal energy and enthalpy are the functions of temperature only. Next question, question number 77. In free expansion process, just now we saw work done is 0, yes, and the heat transfer is also 0. So in case of free expansion process, work done is 0 and heat transfer is 0. Correct answer is option C, both A and B is true. C will be the right answer. Next question, question number 78. If a gas vapor is allowed to expand through a very minute aperture, then such a process is known as throttling. Right? If a gas vapor is allowed to expand through a very minute aperture, so this is the gas and this is the whole minute aperture, and this gas is allowed to expand from this aperture, that process is known as throttling. Option E is the right answer. Question number 79. The specific heat of air increases with what? So the specific heat of air, it is increases with the increase in temperature. The correct answer is option A, temperature. Question number 80. If a fluid expands suddenly into vacuum through an orifice of large dimension, then such process is called as what? The process is known as free expansion. See, this is a container and the two parts of the container, in this the fluid present or gas present, and in this part is totally vacuum. And when we put a hole or put an orifice in between the partition, and this gas is allowed to flow in the vacuum, expand into the vacuum, that process is known as free expansion, right? Correct answer is option A. Next question, question number 81. Which of the following processes are thermodynamically reversible? So which of the following processes are reversible process? The correct answer for this is isothermal process and adiabatic process. So these two processes are thermodynamically reversible process of isothermal and adiabatic. In isothermal, temperature is constant, and adiabatic, heat is constant. Next, question number 82. Which of the following process is irreversible process? So which of the following is irreversible process? Throttling is irreversible. Keep in mind, throttling is irreversible process. And what is meant by throttling? So the gas is means when we allow to expand the gas through a minute aperture, that process is known as throttling, and that process is nothing but irreversible process. Next question. In order that a cycle be reversible, following must be satisfied. So what is the condition for reversible? The first one, free expansion or friction resisted. Yeah, it should be free from friction. Friction resisted expansion or compression process should not be encountered. Correct. First is correct. When heat is being absorbed, the temperature of hot source and working substance should be same. Yeah, that is also correct. The sink temperature, source temperature should be same. When the heat is being rejected, the temperature of cold source and working substance should be same. That is also correct. The correct answer is option D, all of the above. Right? For reversible, the conditions are, it should be free from friction, and the source, hot source and working substance, the temperature should be same. Cold source and working substance temperature should be same. Next question, question number 84. For a thermodynamic process to be reversible, the temperature difference between a hot body and a working substance should be zero. Okay, so difference means though these two temperatures should be same, so the difference between them is zero. Correct answer is option A, zero. Next question, question number 93. Some questions are skipped. Question number 93. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but can be converted from one form to another form, is related to which theorem or which law? So that is nothing but the first law of thermodynamics. It's the conservation of energy. The first law of thermodynamics, in that it states that the energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but can be converted from one form to other form. Question number 94. First law of thermodynamics furnishes the relationship between what? The first law of thermodynamics furnishes the relationship between heat, work and properties of the system. The correct answer is option B, heat, work and properties of the system. Zeroth law, it relates to the temperature, and the second law of thermodynamics, it relates to the entropy. Next question, question number 95. Change in enthalpy in a closed system is equal to the heat transferred if the reversible process takes place at what? Constant pressure. What is meant by enthalpy? So what is the change in enthalpy in a closed system? That is nothing but equal to the heat transferred if the reversible process takes place at a constant pressure. Correct answer is option A, pressure. In an isothermal process, the internal energy what? So it remains constant. The internal energy in isothermal process, it remains constant. Question number 97. Ch- change in internal energy in a closed system is equal to the heat transfer if the reversible process takes place at what? So the reversible process takes place at constant volume. Okay, so the statement like change in internal energy in a closed system is equal to the heat transfer if the work done is zero, that is nothing but if the reversible process takes place at constant volume. If volume is constant, then work done will be zero, because integration of P, dV, V is constant, then work done is zero. And then the change in internal energy is equal to change in heat transfer, because work done is zero. Correct answer is option C, volume. Question number 98. According to the first law of thermodynamics, heat and work are mutually convertible. So this stage, the first law of thermodynamics, like heat and work are mutually convertible. Option C is the right answer. Question number 99. Total heat of the substances is known as what? The total heat of a substance is known as enthalpy. So enthalpy is the content of heat. Option D is the right answer. Question number 100. First law of thermodynamics. So what is the first law of thermodynamics? What are the statements? First, enable to determine the change in internal energy. Yes, it determines the change in internal energy. Does not help to predict whether the system will or undergo a change or not. So first law will not help to predict whether the system will or will not undergo a change. Yeah, that helps by using second law of thermodynamics. Option C, does not enable to determine the change in entropy. Yes, because entropy is related to the second law of thermodynamics. And option D, provides the relationship between the heat, work and internal energy. Yes. So the both four statements are correct, and these are related to the first law of thermodynamics, right? The correct answer is option E, all of the above. So these are the next 50 questions I have covered. And if you want to watch the earlier videos, earlier 50 questions that I have covered in the part 1 of thermodynamics, so you can go to the playlist BMC J 2019 and you can watch this video. And this is related to the mechanical branch, but electrical students can also watch this videos, because in exam both mechanical branch questions and electrical branch questions will be there. So watch this video, this will be useful for you guys also, electrical and mechanical also. So if you like this video, then like, comment. If you have any doubt, then comment in comment box, and subscribe to my government track channel and press the bell icon so that you will get the more updates. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.